Hey, it's time for an apple fritter. Here's your host, Jimmy Apple.
Welcome to another episode of An Apple a Day's The Fritter. I'm your host, Jimmy Apple. How you feeling today, my friends? You feeling good? You feeling strong? You feeling better than you did yesterday? Excellent. You can't ask for better than that. Today we're talking about compression stockings. You wear compression stockings to improve your blood flow in the veins of your legs. Compression stockings gently squeeze your legs to move blood up your legs. This helps prevent leg swellings and, to a lesser extent, blood clots. If you have varicose veins, spider veins, or have just had surgery, your healthcare provider may prescribe compression stockings. Wearing compression stockings helps with aching and heavy feelings in your legs, swelling in your legs, preventing blood clots primarily after surgery or injury when you are less active, preventing complications of blood clots in your legs such as post-phlebitic syndrome, pain and swelling in your legs. Talk to your provider about what kind of compression stockings are right for you. There are many different compression stockings. They come in different pressures, from light pressure to strong pressure, lengths from knee-high to top of the thigh, and colors. Follow instructions on how long each day you need to wear your compression stockings. You may need to wear them all day. The stockings should feel strong around your legs. You will feel the most pressure around your ankles and less pressure higher up on your legs. Put on stockings first thing in the morning before you get out of bed. Your legs have the least amount of swelling early in the morning. Hold the top of your stockings and roll down to the heel. Put your foot into the stockings as far as you can. Put your heel into the heel of the stockings. Pull the stockings up. Unroll the stockings up over your legs. After the top of the stockings are in place, smooth out any wrinkles. Do not let the stockings bunch up or wrinkle. Knee-length stockings should come up to 2 fingers below the knee bend. If it's hard to put the stockings on, try these tips. Apply some lotion on your legs, but let it dry before you put on the stockings. Use a little baby powder or cornstarch on your legs. This may help the stockings slide up. Put on rubber dishwashing gloves to help adjust the stockings and smooth out the wrinkles. Use a special gadget called the stocking donner to slide the stocking up over your foot. You can buy this at any medical supply store or online. Keep your stockings clean. Wash the stockings each day with mild soap and water. Rinse and air dry. If you can, have 2 pairs. Wash 1 pair each day and wash and dry the other. Replace your stockings every 3 to 6 months so that they maintain their support. If your stockings feel too uncomfortable, call your provider. Find out if there's a different kind of stocking that will work for you. Do not stop wearing the stockings without talking to your provider. Now, these stockings come with different names. They can be called compression hose, pressure stockings, support stockings, gradient stockings, varicose vein compression stockings, or venous insufficiency compression stockings. Whatever you want to call them, they're compression stockings. And wearing them just might save your life because they do work at preventing blood clots. So there you have it. I want to thank you for stopping by today. I really appreciate it. And I want to remind you, the Apple Fritter comes out 5 days a week, every morning at 4 a.m. That's right, we're up baking the fritter at 4 a.m. just for you. And I also want to remind you of this, my friends. No matter what, things can always be worse. That's right, things can always be worse. Right now, there's somebody somewhere wishing that they were in your position. So things can always be worse. Now, every day I tell you, do yourself a favor, do me a favor. Go out there and be the reason that somebody smiles. And you're probably saying, how am I going to make somebody smile? I'm not going to be a jackass and dance around for them. You know what? All it takes maybe is a kind word, a handshake, a pat on the back. Just saying hello to somebody can make them smile. So do something to make somebody smile today. Hey, you've been listening to an Apple Fritter. My name is Jimmy Apple. I'm going to talk to you again. Have a great day today, my friends.
Join Jimmy tomorrow for another Apple Fritter. In the meantime, stop over at our YouTube group page, Living with a Disability. Join in the conversation and make some new friends. See you next time.